Tonight, boating tragedy. Two people drown after their craft capsizes off Coral Bay. A disgraced senior bureaucrat admits to his part in one of WA's biggest cases of corruption. Victims of the Stirling First collapse take their fight to the steps of the corporate watchdog. Perth drivers reveal their biggest pet peeves while behind the wheel. And how two horses on the loose caused traffic chaos in the southern suburbs.
This is 10 News First, Perth, with Monika Kos.
First tonight, there has been a tragic ending to a sea search off our coast after a boat capsized in Coral Bay. Four people were on board the vessel when it ran into trouble. Chiara Zaffino joins us live from the newsroom. Chiara, what can you tell us?
Monika, authorities were alerted to the emergency at about 8:30 last night. That's when the 6-metre vessel ran into trouble just off Maud's Landing, around 7 kilometres off Coral Bay. It's believed it overturned on a reef while returning to shore. On board were four people. Two of them managed to swim to safety and get help. Last night, crews searched for the boat. They set out again this morning, and that's when it was spotted from the air just before 8. Police say the man and woman were sadly found dead on board, their bodies brought back to shore. Monika, the two people who survived are receiving medical treatment in Coral Bay.
Chiara, thank you. There's been another delay for the AlQH sheep ship that's been languishing in Fremantle Port for almost a month. 35,000 sheep were today loaded onto the vessel after a legal challenge from animal activists failed to stop the export to the Middle East during summer. Rough weather has now delayed the ship's departure. It'll be anchored in Coburn Sound until Friday. All crew is back on board after 21 of them contracted COVID-19 last month. Aussie actor Ernie Dingo says he retaliated after being racially abused at Perth train station this morning. The star of movies like Crocodile Dundee and Brand New Day posted to Facebook that a white man in his 30s made the comment as he got off the train. Dingo says he chased the culprit down and whacked him in the head. The 63-year-old says at his age he won't cop any abuse. It's believed the confrontation was captured by a security camera. Neither police nor the PTA have received a complaint. There's been a major development in one of WA's biggest corruption scandals. Former senior bureaucrat Paul White has today pleaded guilty to 530 charges for his part in a $22 million rort of taxpayers' money.
For 11 years, Paul White used his position as a senior public servant to steal millions of dollars from WA taxpayers. He was working for the Department of Communities, but money that should have gone towards helping the vulnerable was stolen through a fake invoicing scam. Today, White pleaded guilty to 530 charges for his part in the $22 million rort.
This has been weighing on his conscience from for a long time.
White faced court via video link from Haghia Prison, but had to plead guilty in writing because it would have taken hours to plead to each of the 530 offences. He's also facing a new charge of laundering more than $250,000.
Been assisting the police. He has sat down with them for hours and hours going through all the offending. And there's no surprise about this new charge. This has, in effect, come by his own disclosure.
Although he's been granted bail, Paul White has chosen not to take it. Instead, he'll remain here at Haghia Prison. His time in custody will be taken into account during his sentencing.
Well, look, at this stage, you know, imprisonment is inevitable. So some people often choose to start their sentence before they're actually sentenced. That's an option he can do.
After his arrest late last year, Paul White tried to take his life while he was on bail at his Mosman Park home. His lawyer says he's now doing well.
Yep, really good.
He's good?
Yeah, you can say he's looking well and yes. Mental state's quite good at the moment.
White will face court again in August. Lee Steele for 10 News First.
A Perth woman accused of stealing from a dying elderly friend has faced court. Police say Tai Mai Ann Pham stole money from the man in his 80s on numerous occasions. He's since died. The 41-year-old from Dianella has been charged with 47 counts of stealing and will front court again in July. Elderly victims of the failed Stirling First scheme have taken to the streets to protest against ASIC. They say the corporate watchdog was negligent and want the federal government to pay the $19 million owed to them.
They've lost everything, But they're not going down without a fight.
We want our money. When do you want it now?
Forced to protest in the streets, elderly victims of the failed Sterling First rental scheme are demanding justice.
This is disgraceful. People of this age, especially coming out of COVID-19, shouldn't have to do this.
More than 100 West Aussies poured their life savings into the Rent for Life scheme, which collapsed in March 2019, leaving some of them homeless.
$200,000 down the drain. $200,000 down the drain. That was our life savings.
Lost a lot. It was horrible. And it's been the worst 12 months of my life.
The case is before the High Court, with ASIC pursuing the company behind the Sterling Trust. But the residents say that ASIC was negligent from the start, and the federal government should cough up the $19 million owed to them.
9 Sterling First residents have passed away waiting for compensation, and 4 more are seriously ill. They say they're running out of time.
Everybody's on bloody antidepressant, sleeping tablets. It's just shocking. Shocking what they've done.
We're not going to give up. It doesn't matter what happens. I mean, some people are on oxygen bloody tanks. They just didn't come today, but the rest of us are here trying our best.
Brendan Crew for 10 News First.
The person who abducted and killed Kira Glennon and Jane Rimmer may have taken souvenirs from their bodies. That's the allegation from state prosecutors, who say Bradley Robert Edwards is the Claremont serial killer.
When Jane Rimmer's naked body was discovered in bushland south of Perth, her remains were badly decomposed. Months later, a walker stumbled upon the body of Kira Glennon. She was clothed but missing the shoes, bag and jacket she'd been wearing during her final night out in Claremont. Despite extensive searches of the crime scenes, both victims' personal effects have never been found. And today, lead prosecutor Carmel Barbagello suggested they may have been taken by their killer as grim souvenirs. Whether the assailant retained those items as trophies or whether he disposed of them, we don't know. The missing items, just one of a string of striking similarities between the two murders, which the state says point to one killer, Bradley Robert Edwards. It's alleged both women were snatched from Claremont and driven to a remote location where they were murdered, their bodies dumped face down, then covered by vegetation. It's claimed they both fought for their lives, suffering defensive wounds to their arms. And locals in Wellard heard Jane Rimmer screaming for her life and having her throat cut. The fibres located on their bodies and a Telstra-issue knife found near the Wellard scene allegedly point to Edwards. While the state accepts the knife may not be the murder weapon, they say it helps to place Edwards in Wellard, left or dropped by the accused on the night Jane Rimmer died. And any other scenario is too much of a coincidence. Sarah Spears' body has never been found, and with no forensic evidence linking Edwards to her death, her case is the most difficult to prove. Claire Dirrell for 10 News First.
A man has faced court over a Mahogany Creek crash which killed a pregnant 21-year-old and her unborn baby. Police say 23-year-old Jesse James Matthews was behind the wheel of a blue Ford Falcon last month when it smashed into a Nissan Skyline carrying heavily pregnant Maddie Morgan and her partner Jack Bryant. He was critically injured and she died in hospital. Matthews appeared in Midland Magistrates Court today on several charges, including dangerous driving causing death. He'll reappear in August. The federal government's joining a High Court push to reopen state borders in the wake of the COVID-19 pandemic. It's divided legal experts who say WA could have a case to remain closed.
It's the border fight that has turned state against state. After South Australia opened up to Western Australia, the Northern Territory and Tasmania, sparking fierce backlash.
And I think it's crazy.
Well, look, I don't want to be offensive to South Australians, but why would you want to go there?
I'd encourage everybody to come and visit South Australia.
But WA is not playing ball. Premier Mark McGowan still refusing to budge, keeping our border firmly shut and dashing any hopes of a travel bubble with any other states, a move that has angered the Commonwealth.
And certainly we need to make sure that we get those border closures ended.
As it joins Clive Palmer's High Court challenge.
Our argument is that they are no longer lawful or constitutional.
Section 92 of the Constitution says borders between states shall be absolutely free. That's the Commonwealth's argument for why border closures are unconstitutional.
Those decisions are going to be tested very soon in the courts.
States like WA argue health advice trumps it, given recent COVID clusters in New South Wales and 21 fresh cases in Victoria today. But constitutional experts argue it's not that clear-cut.
States have got advice, the Commonwealth's got advice, they're disagreeing, but it just shows this is a grey area. There's no certainty in this area, there's no clear precedent until the seven judges of the High Court give us a ruling.
But that is likely to be months away, meaning the High Court challenge could end up being a very expensive waste of money.
Well, it's quite possible we'll have seen a large political stoush, a lot of money spent on lawyers, but in the end, no resolution in court simply because the borders open first.
Natalie Forrest for 10 News First.
The worst habits of WA motorists have been laid bare in a new survey by the RAC. And while most of the bad behaviour won't come as a surprise, experts say it's not hard to be a better driver.
The bad habits behind these crashes, enough to frustrate anyone on the road.
What are you doing, mate?
These aren't just inconsiderate things. These are potentially life-saving issues or will stop a serious injury on our road.
The RAC asked WA drivers what their biggest pet peeves were, and the answers were clear. Failing to merge was one of the worst offenders. We're also not very good at indicating.
It's still surprising that people find it very difficult to indicate. It's very simple to do, and we're asking people to simply show their intention when they come to a roundabout, they're changing lanes or they're turning.
And West Australians are serial tailgaters.
One right up your backside when you're going at the speed limit.
Merging? That's a real classic West Australia driver fault.
Not merging properly, I guess. No, not staying in their side of the lane.
Poor roundabout etiquette is probably number one, followed closely by tailgating.
But the very worst of our bad behaviour, not pulling over for emergency crews.
It's not just about being a considerate driver. If you don't slow down and pull over for an emergency vehicle, you could receive 3 demerit points and a $300 fine.
The best advice is to stay calm, indicate and pull to the left-hand side if it's safe. Luckily, it's not hard to be a better driver.
Indicate, drive safely, keep a safe distance, and a bit of old-fashioned courtesy goes a long way on our roads.
Amelia Simpson for 10 News First.
The state government is one step closer to banning clamping in WA with legislation introduced to Parliament. The laws will put an end to wheel clamping to enforce payment on private properties. There will also be a crackdown on the towing industry, which is often used as a form of parking control.
So there'll be a number of regulations to stop the automatic move from clamping to towing, because we know that has happened in other states.
The state government hopes to have clamping banned by the end of the year. Footage has emerged of a dramatic police chase in Rockingham this morning. Officers were called to Ellis Avenue after two horses escaped from a Port Kennedy training facility. Police were on hand to help manage traffic, with the horses safely returned soon after. Time for an early look at sport now. As expected, Cricket Australia has swung the axe, Tim.
Not good, Monica, at all. Staff have been sacked, cricket programs around the country put on hold or dumped altogether. $40 million a year needs to be saved. Cricket in this country is in crisis. Also tonight, it's not all work and no play for our AFL teams. The Eagles and Dockers hit the fairways and the waves as the Gold Coast delivers. And if you're a 19-time Guinness World Record holder, then surely you can write your name into our play of the day. One of the game's biggest names won't be playing tomorrow night. That's coming up later in sport.
See you later. After the break on 10, under attack, confronting vision of a violent arrest caught on body cam. And meet the utterly adorable pups settling into life at Perth Zoo.
Oh, wow.
It's the Elimination Challenge. All MasterChef contestants dread.
Oh, I don't want to do this.
It will send one of your favourites home.
This cube challenge is really hard.
Far out.
No.
And they're doing it blindfolded. Blindfolded.
Oh, no.
Oh, my God. Scary.
When you do have that blindfold on, eating something as simple as, say, a banana just does not taste like a banana.
No picking. Are you ready?
No.
No.
Today is serious and today is not the time to make little silly errors.
And I'm thinking, ooh.
Ah, that's a tough one. That's a tough one.
I have no idea. No idea.
No, I feel really unsure about this one.
You are incorrect.
The Blind Elimination on 10. Ada left. Who goes home? Sunday.
Rental Management Australia is 100% focused on managing properties. We understand clear communication gives you peace of mind, and that's delivering positive word-of-mouth referrals Australia-wide. Rental Management Australia. Your property is our priority.
WA's most famous spuds are coming to Stirling Central Shopping Centre, but there's no need to rush in, because the free spuds or carrots and big opening specials will be there 24 hours a day, all weekend. We grow it, we sell it, you save.
With Choices Flooring, you'll find the colour, style and texture you've been searching for right in your own home with our fun new visualiser, Room View. Visit choicesflooring.com.au and start creating.
Save up to 10% on your first year's premium when you get a new Allianz home insurance policy online.
Okay, done.
Get that? Allianz feeling. Search for a quote today.
Here's O'Keefe in the knee slide, making it look so easy.
I tried that at my wedding, split my pants.
For AFL this Thursday and Friday, if your team leads by 6 points or more at halftime, we'll pay you out straight away. Six up, you win with Sportsbet.
The stylish Havel H2, a globally engineered, European-designed and feature-packed SUV. From just $22,990 drive away, Havel H2 Auto. New car thinking.
Okay, long black for Dave, skinny latte for Dave, hot chocky for Dave and cappuccino for David. Who's David?
From a dollar each, shout the team at 7-Eleven.
The Total Tools End of Financial Year Sale event is on this Thursday at all nine stores across WA. Biggest deals on world's best tool brands, plus mega voucher deals. Spend $4.99, get $100. Spend $4,999, get $1,000 to spend on more tools. Total Tools, every tool for every trade.
It's finally safe to go back to the beach. But one girl has found herself in serious danger.
She's so weak, she slips off. I've lost her here.
Where the f*** did she just go?
New Bondi Rescue, 7:30 tonight.
Hello there. We all know COVID-19 has cost jobs and badly impacted some industries more than others. But today, one of the nation's leading business strategists warned just how many could shut up shop. According to Phil Riven's report, we could see one in six businesses close their doors this year and next, instead of the usual one in eight. That's up to 400,000 closures at the peak. Now, 75,000 of those could be due to bankruptcy or receivership. For industries such as hospitality, admin and support services and transport, well, closure rates there could exceed 20%. Now, have a look at this graph. It shows the survival rate by industry. Healthcare and social assistance tops the list, but the already under pressure accommodation and food sector is very much at the bottom. Commuters wanting to avoid public transport because of COVID-19 have been turning to carsales.com. The website says there's been an increase in the last 6 weeks in first-time car buyers and people adding an extra car to the household. But it's not enough to stop warnings of a profit slide of up to 9% this financial year. It was a very choppy day on the share market, but it has managed to close up. Miners lagged, property stocks were higher. And what about Beacon Lighting? It was up 22% after the retailer reported a sales surge from people working from home. To the dollar, it's buying just under 69 US cents. And that's finance.
A female officer's been choked and had her hair torn out during a violent arrest caught on body cam. Police released the vision to show what the two officers were up against and a warning some of the footage may be confronting.
Police say it came out of nowhere.
Don't grab me, mate!
They'd been called to the home for a minor assault, but when they approached the man, he unleashed.
You're a f***wit, you f***wit!
Get in my face.
Grabbing a female officer's hair, tearing it out and choking her.
No, let go! Let go!
Deal with it, you f***wit!
A male officer was elbowed in the face and groin before backup arrives and he's finally restrained.
Get off me!
F***!
The man on the ground is alleged to be 35-year-old William Kershaw. He's been hit with 13 charges and refused bail. Worse still, all this unfolded as three small children watched on from inside.
Having any emergency service officer assaulted is just not on. Enough is enough, and we won't put up with it.
Well, this is exactly the day in the life of the police forces in New South Wales. What we've seen in this footage is what they have to go through and what they risk every day that they go to work.
10 News First understands that Kershaw turned up here drunk and devastated about a relationship breakup with the mother of children who lives here. But when he was told to keep the noise down, he snapped.
The family is okay after barricading themselves inside, but their home was damaged.
We truly are the thin blue line out there trying to protect the community from carnage.
Putting themselves in harm's way.
Let's go!
Deal with it, you deal with it, you
Ursula Hager for 10 News First.
Investigators have laid more charges against the Porsche driver accused of fleeing the scene of a horror crash that killed four Melbourne police officers. Richard Pusey has been slapped with the rare charge of outraging public decency. The offence carries a 2-year jail term. He's already facing a raft of driving charges. The 41-year-old is accused of filming the crash scene while complaining about his wrecked car. A man accused of robbing a cerebral palsy sufferer has pleaded not guilty. The theft was caught on a bank's security camera and was condemned across the country.
20-year-old Jared Elphick ducking and weaving outside court today. Seemingly very aware of our cameras, but oblivious, it's alleged, to this security camera at Haymarket, which police claim caught him stealing $100 just withdrawn from an ATM by Julian Stewart, who uses a wheelchair because of his cerebral palsy.
Jared, is there anything you want to say to Julian?
He appeared to say sorry.
I hope that now he moves on, realises he's made a very big mistake.
But inside court today, Elphick entered a plea of not guilty to a charge of steal from person. Exactly why, he declined to say. Sprinting away from our questions.
I'm a disabled person going about my life. He's an able-bodied person with his whole life in front of him.
Elphick handed himself into police 2 days after the robbery. So did Nathan Laidlaw, who allegedly helped pinch the cash.
When the security video from here at the bank was first released, there was widespread community outrage. Incredibly, though, Julian offered his forgiveness almost straight away. Now, though, it appears he'll have to endure a lengthy court process and may have to give evidence at a hearing.
Well, it's very frustrating. I mean, everyone's got to look at themselves in the mirror, and I want them to be able to do that with pride and dignity every time they do it.
Both accused robbers will be back in court in August. Daniel Sutton for 10 News First.
A litter of endangered Asian small-clawed otter pups has passed its first health checks at Perth Zoo. The pups, which are now 2 months old, had their eyes, ears and teeth checked. There are three males and one female in the litter, and they are now old enough to start swimming lessons. Plenty of rain about the place this afternoon. Michael Schultz is here. There is more to come.
Plenty of wind too, Mon. To the south of Lake Clifton across to Bremer Bay, there's still a severe weather warning in place for gusts to 100 kilometres an hour. There's been gusts to 117 around the southwest capes, and Mandurah had a gust to 94 kilometres an hour. Here are the rainfall figures around the metropolitan area. Perth has had 11.2 millimetres. That takes the total for the month to 54.4 millimetres. One of the better falls is one of the Jarrodale sites has had 19. The maximum got to 22.7. That was early in the day at 13 past 11. The overnight minimum before midnight once again was 9.2 degrees. Around the area, warm in the northerlies ahead of the front, 25 recorded at Launceston, 24 at Ballsbrook, but only 2 this morning at Northam. The satellite image shows the system moving into the southwest land division. The best falls been Mount William to the south of Mandurah, 36 millimetres, and into Katanning and Wagen, there's been around 13 or 14. More details at 5 to 6.
Thank you, Michael. Ahead on 10 News, police reform, how Donald Trump's responded to the Black Lives Matter movement, and violent scenes in France as a health workers' protest turned ugly.
Please step aside.
Why?
Because I'm chief of police. I get that I'm new. I get how many people think I don't deserve this.
There are people celebrating because a cop got killed.
Somebody shot him through the window and then torched the car.
The LAPD will not take this lying down.
I got people inside the LAPD that tell me she has no idea about what's going on.
Someone in this office leaked to the press to undermine me. I want to know who. I need to know how long it's going to be till my officers trust me.
The new series, Tommy, 8:30 tonight.
This is Terrace, the narrow lot design specialists changing the way Perth lives. Terrace is everywhere, with house and land packages in over 33 locations. This is Terrace, and it could be yours from only $299,000.
As this financial year closes, it's been one of the toughest for many of us. Sunboost, Australia's largest solar company, is stepping up to help Australians save and generate funds at this critical time. And you can accelerate your recovery with an end of financial year Sunboost discount on the most popular family size solar package.
Boost your financial recovery with a limited $200 end of financial year discount on this premium 6.6 kilowatt system, fully installed for just $31.91, only until June 30. So call 1300 Sunboost today.
Sam O'Keefe in the sock slide. This is it. Come on, Slippery. On the runway. Slides. It's big. It's a new world record!
Somebody stop her! She'll slide out the stadium!
That make it look easy moment was brought to you by Sportsbet's new AFL Player Hub. Now it's easy to find all your favourite player markets in the one spot. You can even add them to a same game multi for bigger odds. AFL Player Hub. Try it now with Sportsbet.
Financial year sale event is on this Thursday at all nine stores across WA. Biggest deals on world's best tool brands, plus mega voucher deals. Spend $4.99, get $100. Spend $4,999, get $1,000 to spend on more tools. Total Tools, every tool for every trade.
Is extras cover worth it right now?
Well, many healthcare providers like physios and dentists are open and ready to help you stay well. Make sure you're covered with HBF's all new extras. Join HBF today.
Choosing jewellery from solid gold diamonds is more than looking in a shop window. It's a memory for life. You can see an exclusive range of the finest Argyle pink diamonds at prices you'll love. Handcrafted pieces individually designed for you. Rare Argyle pink diamonds are your investment for life. Nothing compares with the solid gold diamonds experience. Upstairs, corner William and Hay Street Mall.
Get moving. Furniture Bazaar's end of financial year sale is here. Get the Palmer Recliner Suite for $1,099. The Aberdeen Bedroom Suite, 30% off. And the Zeus Lounge, now only $14.99.
Furniture Bazaar. WA's most famous spuds are coming to Stirling Central Shopping Centre. But there's no need to rush in, because the free spuds or carrots and big opening specials will be there 24 hours a day, all weekend. We grow it, we sell it, you save.
I just love our new home, and I can't wait to show you around.
Feel Good Fridays are back. The new living room on 10.
North Korea says it will redeploy troops to border units in the demilitarised zone in another sign of rising tensions with the South. Yesterday, it blew up a liaison office set up in 2018 as part of a peace agreement with South Korea. The sister of North Korean dictator Kim Jong-un also today rejected the South's offer to send special envoys to defuse the crisis. She says the action is in response to anti-Kim propaganda leaflets being sent across the border from South Korea. There are fears of a conflict between the world's two largest nations after a deadly border clash between Indian and Chinese soldiers. At least 20 Indian troops were killed in the vicious confrontation that included iron rods and stones in the disputed Himalayan border region. China hasn't confirmed reports. It also suffered multiple casualties. Tension has been high for several weeks, with India accusing China of sending thousands of troops into its territory. But this is the first deadly border clash between between the nuclear-armed neighbours in almost 50 years. Donald Trump's move to change police operations across the country. The US president is calling it an historic moment for law enforcement, but his critics say the order doesn't come close to what's needed.
Having just met privately with families of black men and women killed by police...
Your loved ones will not have died in vain.
President Donald Trump tried to answer a nation crying out for change.
Thank you all for being here as we take historic action.
Trump signed an executive order not requiring any immediate action, but rather encouraging police departments to adopt high standards for use of force policies. Chokeholds should be banned except when a police officer's life is in danger.
Nobody is more opposed to the small number of bad police officers, and you have them. They're very tiny. I use the word tiny. It's a very small percent.
His opponents are calling it another photo op.
We heard from President Trump that he was going to have a very strong executive order, and it's weak tea.
This is not enough. It does not meet this moment.
In Oklahoma, Trump supporters have already begun queuing for a rally on Saturday.
This being the first rally back after, what, 2 months, 3 months? I wasn't going to miss this one.
And while the campaign will hand out masks, local officials fear the 20,000-seat stadium will be a COVID super-spreading event. All as Texas, Florida and Arizona today recorded more daily cases than at any other time of the outbreak.
Here in New York, cases are declining and the city is technically in lockdown, but many of the restaurants that are supposed to be only offering takeout are blatantly breaching the rules.
A country both weary and ready to reopen. Eamon Ashton-Atkinson for 10 News First, New York.
Another 31 people have tested positive for coronavirus in Beijing, taking the city's toll to 137 since last Thursday. 27 neighbourhoods are now in lockdown and Chinese authorities have suspended all school classes in the capital. The outbreak has been linked to a food market, which had been receiving tens of thousands of visitors a day. In Paris, what began as a march demanding better pay for healthcare workers descended into a series of violent clashes with riot police. Officers say they fired tear gas to disperse anarchists who threw stones and even overturned a car. 19 police were injured in the chaos. And the usually tranquil French city of Dijon resembles a war zone after 4 nights of violent clashes, reportedly between Chechen and North African gang members. The parents of missing British toddler Madeleine McCann have denied receiving a letter from German prosecutors declaring their daughter was dead. The McCanns have issued a statement on Find Madeleine website stating the story has caused unnecessary anxiety to family and friends. Meanwhile, a German TV station has aired a report claiming the suspect, Christian B, kept children's clothes and swimwear in his van while living in Portugal. And both the driver and passenger of this sedan have miraculously survived, being crushed in between two trucks in southern China. They were waiting for the lights to change when one truck slammed into them from behind, pushing their car into a cement mixer. Both occupants were taken to hospital and are reportedly in a stable condition. After the break, desperate escape. A wanted driver tries to outrun police. And the moment these stolen puppies were returned to their owners.
At the new time of 7:30 Thursday.
I don't remember him having his shirt open like that.
Mama, are you feeling him?
The celebs go crazy for Swayze.
They looked like they were doing the dance.
Well, that's why it's called dirty dancing.
Celebrity Gogglebox USA at the new time, 7:30 Thursday.
Nescafe Blend 43 is made right here in country Queensland. Robusta and Arabica roasted individually, then brought together for the perfect cup. Nescafe Blend 43, the perfect blend of bold and smooth.
Even though we're further apart physically now, it feels like we're closer together.
Physical distancing and good personal hygiene play an essential part in getting our economy back on track. This is a shared journey, and we're all in it together. Authorised by the State Government, Perth.
Thank you.
WA. Now's your chance to dream with the $20 million Saturday Lotto Super Draw. So get your tickets and play for WA.
When it comes to any property, it's what's inside that counts. We understand that the true value of any home is the life inside.
Manolo, you're so cold. Come in. What's wrong?
It's dry.
Your scalp
might get dry in the winter too. Try Head and Shoulders Dry Scalp Care.
It nourishes the scalp and keeps you up to 100% flake-free. Head and Shoulders Dry Scalp Care.
For the mid-afternoon naps. For the midnight marathons. For bringing the family together. For a chance to escape from the world. For the good times and the other times. For the years of support. Danks Furniture. The comfort of home.
The no BS attitude. Can't believe I didn't try them earlier.
Another real review from a happy Aussie broadband customer. With thousands of five-star reviews, an award-winning NBN network and all Australian support, why wait any longer? Aussie broadband. Can't beat feedback.
I help kids learn to be safe, but I'm not a teacher.
I'm helping to make our roads safer, but I'm not an engineer.
I'm working for a more sustainable future, but I'm not a scientist.
I've helped save hundreds of lives, but I'm not a doctor.
I save my family money every day, but I'm not an accountant.
I'm an RAC member.
Doing more for WA and for you. That's the power of membership. RAC. For the better.
Oh, I don't want to do this.
It's the Elimination Challenge. All MasterChef contestants dread.
Oh my God, scary.
Sunday.
The top stories here on 10 News First. There's been a sad ending to a sea search off Coral Bay. Two bodies were found after a boat capsized last night. Two others swam to safety. Stormy weather has forced another setback for the Alkuwait sheep ship. 35,000 sheep bound for the Middle East were loaded on board today, with the ship being anchored in Coburn Sound until weather clears on Friday. And disgraced bureaucrat Paul White has pleaded guilty to WA's biggest case of public sector fraud. Appearing in court from Hakea Prison, White entered pleas to 530 charges for his part in a $22 million rort of taxpayers' money. The heartbroken parents of a 15-year-old boy stabbed to death outside a Melbourne shopping centre say they forgive his alleged killer. They visited the scene today, remembering him as a humble and funny boy with strong ties to his local church.
He's so humble. He's active. He's funny.
Homicide detectives spent the day searching for evidence. Six boys aged between 13 and 16 have since faced the children's court, charged with violent disorder and affray. An Adelaide man's been caught on camera performing a dangerous stunt to try to evade police. The 29-year-old, wanted on driving charges, scaled three stories down the face of a block of apartments, launching himself from balcony to balcony before running across a veranda and leaping onto a parked car. That's when a waiting officer pounced. He was arrested and charged with a string of offences. And it looks like he won't taste freedom again until at least his next court appearance in July. Coronavirus hasn't stopped work on the new museum, with a project still on track to open in November. Construction has employed just short of 3,500 people during the pandemic. Today, a sneak peek revealed that the galleries are starting to take shape, with items from the state collection put on display.
When we have, of course, visitors able to come back into Western Australia, be they from interstate and internationally, this will be a magnificent, magnificent storytelling, a place of storytelling.
Admission to the new museum will be free for the first 18 months. Tails were wagging this morning when four stolen puppies were reunited with their mum. It seems thieves dumped the tiny German shepherds after discovering they'd been microchipped.
Taken from home and left all alone. After a rough night, police found these four stolen puppies dumped in a front yard and administered a much-needed pat-down.
So a lady was just walking her child to school, saw four puppies in the front yard and said they look familiar from Facebook.
Their owners took to social media after thieves stole these canine cuties yesterday afternoon. We were there as police reunited the pups with Dad.
I didn't sleep at all last night. I was literally dreaming about my puppies.
The team of puppy pinchers thought they'd hatched the perfect plan.
Yeah, someone knocked literally on the door. There was a couple other people over the fence collecting the dogs and they're speaking to my girlfriend, interrupting her, and then they're taking the puppies. This is the saddest thing they can ever do.
They clearly got cold feet when they learned the pooches had been microchipped.
You want one? There you go.
After a short car trip home...
Thank you, guys. Thank you so much.
They quickly caught sight of Mum Milo. Wasn't she over the moon? In a day full of them, there was just one more reunion to come.
The thieves may have been swift when they jumped the fence and stole the puppies, but this little guy was the only one left behind.
Oh, hey, little guy.
This German shepherd mama had her flock back together again.
Thank you to the public, yeah. They've done a very great job.
Come on over here.
Yum, yum, yum.
Family fed. There was nothing left to say except, thanks, Dad. Christina Castalis for 10 News First.
A very happy mama indeed. Goss is here with sport. You've been talking up tonight's play of the day all day.
Driven you mad, I know. I think it's one of the best for a while. So you stick around and judge for yourself. Also, the Eagles aim to get back on course after being derailed by the Suns. We hear from their milestone man, Andrew Gaff. And once again, German giants Bayern find a way of winning and they celebrate in style.
How actor Kat Stewart is helping communities impacted by COVID tonight.
It's finally safe to go back to the beach. But is it safe to go back into the water?
This situation's getting out of control really quickly.
Get an ambulance.
New Bondi Rescue, 7:30 tonight.
Getting back on the road is something we're all looking forward to. And at Toyota, we're here to help you do just that. Our dealerships are still open and we have a range of finance options that can help you get behind the wheel of your new car.
Get Corolla Hatch Ascent Sport petrol from $96 per week and 3.9% finance with Toyota Access. Visit your local dealer to find out more. Oh, what a feeling. Toyota.
Thanks to Light and Easy, Australians of all ages can enjoy their choice of delicious, nutritious meals in the comfort and safety of their own home. Especially those at a greater health risk during these times. If you or someone close to you could benefit by having Light and Easy meals delivered safely with our contactless delivery service, visit lightandeasy.com.au or call us on 13 15 12.
At Go Homes, we're making it easy to be a gourmet chef with our exclusive Go Gourmet home designs. With premium Smeg appliances, stone bench tops, and heaps more mouth-watering inclusions. Head to gohomes.com.au.
One better, two better, three better, four. Pink, purple, orange, whatever coloured door. This is your place, your haven, your home. A nest for your loved ones, the odd quirky gnome. Training indoors, more time with your crew. Yoga, then tea, yes, a biscuit or two. Enjoy your castle, get comfy, get cozy. Hang with your besties, it's all rosy. Home is where the heart is. Bankwest, bank less.
EOFY sale now on at Furniture Bazaar in partnership with Slumbercare. Take a huge 60% off Slumbercare OrthoGel luxury mattresses. Slumbercare mattresses, handmade in WA with a 10-year warranty. And the Riverton bedroom suite, 50% off.
Your drinking could contribute to a weaker immune system. To stay healthy and well, it's important to drink at low risk levels. Try alcohol-free days, low alcohol alternatives, and avoid stocking up. Reduce your drinking to reduce your risk.
We've always had a few cars. They're all special. The T-Bird.
Oh, that's mine.
The Combi for when we want to get away. The XR8.
It's going to be a classic.
They're all insured with Shannon's.
We've also got Shannon's home and contents cover,
which helps protect our automotive collectibles, tools and memorabilia in the home and garage. If you're motoring enthusiasts like us, it's got to be
Shannon's.
Shannon's, insurance for motoring enthusiasts. Call 134646 for a quote.
Australians of all ages are choosing Light and Easy. Light and Easy can even assist those on aged care home care packages. If you or someone close to you could benefit by having healthy meals delivered, call us on 13 15 12.
Well, to sport everyone, barely a year goes by without talk that Andrew Gaff wants to head home to Victoria. Well, on Saturday night, the star midfielder steps out for his 200th game, and you get the feeling there'll be more milestones in store as he gets set to stay in WA.
Free to finally play, but his first shot off the tee summed up the Eagles' week.
Yeah, shanked the first ball. The ball looked like the size of an ant on the first tee, so was never going to hit that well.
Take two and a much better result. Andrew Gaff expecting his teammates to keep their eye on the ball against Brisbane.
We expect better of ourselves, and we've got a team that's played a lot of senior football together over so many years, a lot of experienced guys with a lot of success as well, that we expect close to perfection, and that was a long way off that.
Adding to the motivation, Saturday will be the midfielder's 200th appearance. Mr. Consistent, rarely missing a game over his 10 years and expected to trigger a clause in his contract to stay in Eagles colours beyond this season.
I've loved and continue to love every part of playing at this footy club.
His love for West Coast tested when opposition clubs threw multi-million dollar contracts at him at the end of 2018. Gaff was also dealing with an ill father, a lengthy suspension and the heartache of missing out on a premiership medal.
Very lucky to play at a successful club, and there's no guarantees of whether you get another chance to hopefully win a flag as everyone wants to do, but everything was and is going really well here.
A crowd of 2,000 people will be allowed into the Gabba to watch the game. 50 tickets have been offered to Queensland-based Eagles supporters. Gaff's milestone and Jamie Cripps' 150-game celebration could get a little awkward.
We'll try and cheer them both off, and they'll probably hate it who they're going to wave to.
Skipper Luke Shuey continues to recover from a barrage of bumps on the weekend, but still has time to prove his fitness. It was a big Wednesday for the Dockers on their day off, and no surprise to see Nat Fyfe and Connor Blakely don the wetsuit, grab the board and catch some waves. The AFL easing restrictions on our two teams while they hunker down in the hub, with surfing and golf now permitted.
How you feeling?
Oh, a bit nervous.
Bailey Banfield chasing a few birdies before hitting the books. Lockie Reed for 10 News First.
With rule changes and the state of the game on the agenda, Buddy Franklin has called on league bosses to go back to the future. The Star Swan wants the length of the season as well as quarters to go back to normal next year. But he does want one rule change, the reintroduction of the third man up rule.
So you've got the two rucks competing, but I like when you'd be able to have the third man up. I think that rule should be brought back, because then it will open up the play so much more and it'll be so much more free-flowing.
Good to hear from you, bud. The 33-year-old is on the sidelines until late in the season after his latest serious hamstring injury. Luke Beveridge isn't hitting the panic button after his club's slow start to the season, but the Premiership coach will look to add some midfield grunt for their Friday night grudge match against the Giants.
The Dogs are gearing up for what's become one of the nastier rivalries in modern footy. Last year, the captain was clawed.
Oh, Toby Green came in late there.
And the Dogs exited the finals without a whimper, but the coach is talking down, seeking retribution or looking for rough stuff.
The important thing is that when push comes to shove, that you win the game of football.
Tough Premiership midfielder Tom Liberatore looks likely to play.
He had a really good session on Saturday, and he's come through that with flying colours, and that was probably his last one he needed to tick off.
Toby McLean is also in the mix, although he might not be the Toby at the forefront of the coach's mind.
You know, there's a couple of Tobys playing on Friday night if Toby McLean plays, and it does rhyme with green, doesn't it? Look, Toby will be considered.
Beveridge denies the Dogs are flat, but admits there's been problems aplenty in the opening two rounds.
In midfield and our back line and our counter-attack and our stuff out of stoppage hasn't been anywhere near as productive as it was last year.
As for talk about Friday night being make or break in a 17-round season...
It's just another week.
High flyer Aaron Norton is being tipped to fire after a modest start to the season, while the coach is considering drafting in some ruck relief for developing big man Tim English. Nick Butler for 10 News First.
Got some breaking news. A huge blow for Richmond tonight with superstar midfielder Dusty Martin ruled out of the clash with Hawthorn. Rob Waters has more.
Dustin Martin didn't look in any trouble at today's captain's run, but he's the huge out of Richmond's team to play the Hawks with bruised ribs. Josh Caddy comes in to replace him after his calf issues ahead of the Collingwood game.
Yeah, he was stiff last week, obviously, with that calf soreness that we thought he wouldn't take a risk and just take the week rather than possibly, you know, look at two or three down the track.
Liam Baker will unexpectedly miss the game.
Yeah, Bakes has got a personal issue, so he won't play this week. So at this stage, we'll have another player to play. So he's obviously had a family issue that he's gone home for. So we wish him and his family all the very best.
Tom Lynch did the bare minimum at the captain's run, but the club insists he'll play.
Yeah, he'll definitely play. It was part of his program this week. So, you know, from all the information we have, he'll be available to play tomorrow, which is great. He's obviously an important player to the way we structure up.
And the Hawks have named Jager O'Meara to play tomorrow night, and he's returned in the nick of time.
Yeah, on the back of last week's performance, pretty important. You know, we got smacked around the ball last week.
Clarkson labelled last week's midfield effort as fourth rate. Expect them to come out breathing fire against the Tigers.
Whenever you get a fair licking like we did last week in the second half, you know, these guys are proud players, and I'd expect some sort of response.
Hawthorn says it will persist with a defence that contains 4 to 5 talls.
If the weight of evidence suggests that it's really hurting us, then we're going to need to change. And on the back of last week, that's the first step towards change when you get touched up like we did last week. But we also have the view that we need to back it in for a period of time and see how it goes for us.
Rob Waters for 10 News First.
The dismissals keep coming at Cricket Australia a day after Kevin Roberts departed as CEO. A further 40 staff have been made redundant, although Chairman Earl Eddings wouldn't say if any are from the High Performance Department.
I think together we've put a very prudent plan that allows us flexibility, allows us to navigate our way through the next 3 to 4 months and hopefully get to a very exciting summer of Australian cricket.
While grassroots cricket has been protected for the next financial year, the Australia A team won't travel overseas, while junior representative programs such as the Second 11 competition have been temporarily scrapped. The Illawarra Hawks have been saved from financial ruin, but the Illawarra part of their name has been slam dunked. The foundation NBL franchise will remain based in Wollongong, but the new owners want the team simply known as the Hawks in a bid to spread its fan base.
Rebranding the club as the Hawks makes it a team for the region, makes it easier for people to get behind it and support it as a loyal fan. And I think it sits nicely with the strategy of the owners that they've explained it to us.
Former Philadelphia 76ers general manager Brian Colangelo, who helped Ben Simmons become the NBA's top draft pick, is among the new owners. And a bid that included former Hawk and would-be NBA star LaMelo Ball was rejected. The German media has already dubbed them the Ghost Champions, and there was something eerily familiar about this year's Bundesliga title. Bayern Munich claimed an 8th straight crown, and while no fans were watching, the players still did their best to celebrate. Bayern secured the title with a 1-0 win over Werder Bremen. This play of the day requires some patience because the longer the video goes, the better it gets. Dribbling two balls at once isn't easy, but not impossible. what got our attention was the introduction of some juggling from a 19-time Guinness World Record holder. Now, his half-court over-the-head alley-oop assist is impressive, but what won them the play of the day was the fact he finished the trick without ever looking. That's very clever indeed. Hey, tomorrow night we're going to catch up with Justin Langer. The day after, some big news out of Cricket Australia. And after 6 o'clock, we're going to return. An AFL club has just started a petition and it's going to make one other club very unhappy.
Clever and very confident. Confident the ball's going to go in. No, the basketballer.
OK.
We're going to find out if there's any more rough weather on the way after the break. Stay with us.
The drug that researchers claim could save critical COVID-19 patients.
And I'm thinking, ooh.
Oh, that's a tough one. That's a tough one.
I have no idea. No idea.
No, I feel really unsure about this one.
The Blind Elimination, 7:30 Sunday.
Australian governments are now deregistering vehicles fitted with faulty alpha-type Takata airbags. This could be extended to all faulty Takata airbags. Don't risk your registration or your life. Visit ismyairbagsafe.com.au.
All right, Australia, so you need more energy and a better night's sleep. Meet the revolutionary Sleeping Duck mattress taking Australia by storm. It's the next generation mattress reimagined by aerospace engineers to give you the best energy, health and sleep benefits possible, even making history by becoming the first mattress ever to win Choice's Best Overall Mattress 2 years in a row. It comes manufacturer direct, free of markup. And that means you can get incredible quality with incredible value. That's Sleeping Duck, one giant leap for your sleep.
Chloe and Zoe are twins, and Amy customers. So you have the same taste.
We both like our crafted cushions and finished faux fur.
We love our HD, LED, LCD, 4K, pixel TVs.
Do you choose to save now or later on your insurance?
Now. Later.
Buy a home or car insurance policy and Amy Flexi Premiums lets you vary your excess to save now or later. Choose a higher excess to save now or choose a lower excess to save at claim time.
You're with Amy.
Style your home inside and out for less at the Blinds Gallery's new season style sale. Get huge savings across our entire range of indoor and outdoor blinds, curtains, shutters and awnings.
Call 137-127 The Blinds Gallery.
Well, I think he's a gorgeous man, but his hair bothered him. And it bothered me that it bothered him.
So he booked the appointment.
Reached your turning point? The doctors at Ashley and Martin could help regrow your hair.
You can tell the body language when someone loves their hair because they're like an inch taller, they're smiling, and that's what I love. I never want to do anything else.
Our team, making you look and feel the very best you can every time.
The world needs more cooks. Because with a hot pan and a little Lurpak, a cook can tame the wild, feed the hungry, and transform nothing into everything. Where there are cooks, there is hope.
Want to sell something for instant cash? We're open. Looking to buy from a huge range of quality secondhand goods for less? We're open. Cash Converters. Find us online or visit us in store.
We'll take the old grout out and put the new grout in. We'll fix your leaking shell, make it brand new.
Good evening. The winds are going to pick up again during the course of the night and early tomorrow, but there'll be significant moderation by this time tomorrow and the showers should certainly have eased by then. There's been gusts to 117 kilometres an hour at Cape Leeuwin, and at Mandurah there was a gust to 95 kilometres an hour. Now, the rainfall around the metropolitan area has mostly been in the order of 8 to 10 millimetres across the suburbs, a few heavier than that in the hills with 15 at Bickley. Through to Northam there's been 8 millimetres and 5 millimetres at Lance. 22.7 was the maximum today. The overnight minimum was 9.2 and the city recorded 11.2 millimetres of rain. 18 at the moment. The winds are west-south-westerly at 22 kilometres an hour. Barometer is back up to 1,009 and still rising. Relative humidity 64%. It was warm in the northerly ahead of the front, 25 at Launceston today, 24 at Bullsbrook, 23 at Guildford and Jandakot, but a cold start for Northam before the 24. It went down to 2 degrees. Near Northam, York reported 1 degree and that was the lowest overnight minimum. 17 was the lowest maximum at Rocky Gully. Warm in the southeast with 26 at Kalgoorlie and Esperance. The highest in the state was 34. That was recorded at Columbaroo in the far north Kimberley. Mount William, which is to the south of Mandurah in the hills, recorded 36 millimetres, which was the most in the state. And into the agricultural areas, there's been some handy falls. Corrigan's had one report around 10 millimetres and Cunderdon around 13 millimetres. Now, the satellite images shows the system still moving through. There is a severe weather warning for the southwest district and the southern coastal district. So that's basically south of Lake Clifton across to Bremer Bay, where gusts to 100 kilometres an hour are still possible. On the chart, you'll see there is another cold pool moving up onto the southwest coast. There is a gale warning currently from Durian Bay across to Israelite Bay. Strong wind warning runs up the west coast to Kalbarri and across the remainder of the southern coastline to Eucla. The rainfall may extend up to Exmouth overnight and across to Eucla tomorrow. There will be an easing trend during the day in the northern half, and there's going to be showers in the southwest land division contracting south of Durian Bay during the day. There's likely to be some thunderstorm activity south of Mandurah across to Israelite Bay. Dangerous surf conditions near the west coast, and there's likely to be beach erosion, and there is a fire weather warning out for the Eucla division ahead of the front. The major centres tomorrow, showers and storms are possible in Albany and Bunbury. Albany heading for 15. The shower should ease in Esperance. A possible shower in Kalgoorlie early in the day, and it will be partly cloudy in Geraldton and Carnarvon, sunny further north. A shower or two in Brisbane and Cairns, partly cloudy in Sydney, Canberra and Hobart. The rest should be mostly sunny. On our waters, gale warning easing to a strong wind warning tomorrow, and the winds in the middle of the day should be back to 15 to 25 knots, and in the evening they'll be 10 to 15 knots south to southeasterlies. West to southwesterly swell of 4 to 6 metres. The high tide is a little over 1.2 metres. That's at 20 to 8 in the morning. Sunset at 20 past 5. Forecast for Perth, showers easing, 2 to 6 millimetres possible. Could be a thunderstorm in the south and possibly some small hail. The minimum should be down to 11 and tomorrow's maximum reaching 18. Friday, partly cloudy. Colder start, 6 to 18. Saturday should be sunny, 5 to 20. Sunday should also be fine with the top at 22. Showers rolling in late on Monday and continuing through the first half of the week.
Two bodies have been recovered from the water after a boat capsized in Coral Bay. Four people were on board the vessel when it ran into trouble off Maud's Landing and overturned last night. Two people managed to swim to shore and raise the alarm. This morning, crews spotted the stricken boat from the air. Police say two bodies were found on board and brought back to shore. The two survivors are receiving medical treatment. Stormy weather has delayed the Al Kuwait sheep ship from leaving Fremantle Port. Set to sail today, the 35,000 sheep, rather, were loaded onto the vessel after a legal challenge from animal activists failed to stop the export to the Middle East during summer. It will now be anchored in Coburn Sound until the wet weather clears on Friday. A former senior bureaucrat has pleaded guilty to 530 charges in relation to WA's biggest public sector theft. Paul White admitted his involvement in the $22 million rort of taxpayers' money.
For 11 years, Paul White used his position as a senior public servant to steal millions of dollars from WA taxpayers. He was working for the Department of Communities, but money that should have gone towards helping the vulnerable was stolen through a fake invoicing scam. Today, White pleaded guilty to 530 charges for his part in the $22 million rort.
This has been weighing on his conscience for a long time.
Whiteface caught via video link from Hagia Prison but had to plead guilty in writing because it would have taken hours to plead to each of the 530 offences. He's also facing a new charge of laundering more than $250,000.
Been assisting the police. He has sat down with them for hours and hours going through all the offending.
Although he's been granted bail, Paul White has chosen not to take it. Instead, he'll remain here at Hagia Prison. His time in custody will be taken into account during his sentencing.
After his arrest late last year, Paul White tried to take his life while he was on bail at his Mosman Park home. His lawyer says he's now doing well.
Yep, really good.
He's good?
Yeah, you can say he's looking well and yes. Mental state's quite good at the moment.
Lee Steele for 10 News First. Any messages?
Aussie actor Ernie Dingo has revealed he whacked a man who racially abused him at a Perth train station this morning. Taking to Facebook, the Crocodile Dundee 2 star posted that a white man in his 30s made a racial slur as he got off the train. Dingo says he chased the culprit down and hit him in the head. The 63-year-old says at his age he won't cop any abuse. Neither police nor the PTA have received a complaint. The person who abducted and killed Kira Glennon and Jane Rimmer may have taken souvenirs from their bodies. That's the allegation from state prosecutors who say Bradley Robert Edwards is the Claremont serial killer.
When Jane Rimmer's naked body was discovered in bushland south of Perth, her remains were badly decomposed. Months later, a walker stumbled upon the body of Kira Glennon. She was clothed but missing the shoes, bag and jacket she'd been wearing during her final night out in Claremont. Despite extensive searches of the crime scenes, both victims' personal effects have never been found. And today, lead prosecutor Carmel Barbagello suggested they may have been taken by their killer as grim souvenirs. Whether the assailant retained those items as trophies or whether he disposed of them, we don't know. The missing items, just one of a string of striking similarities between the two murders, which the state says point to one killer, Bradley Robert Edwards. The fibres located on their bodies and a Telstra-issue knife found near the Wellard scene allegedly point to Edwards. While the state accepts the knife may not be the murder weapon, they say it helps to place Edwards in Wellard, left or dropped by the accused on the night Jane Rimmer died, and any other scenario is too much of a coincidence. Sarah Spears' body has never been found, and with no forensic evidence linking Edwards to her death, her case is the most difficult to prove. Claire Dirrell for 10 News First.
Elderly victims of the failed Stirling First scheme have taken to the streets to protest against ASIC. They say the corporate watchdog was negligent and want the federal government to pay the $19 million owed to them.
Forced to protest on the streets.
We want our money. When do we want it now?
These elderly victims of the failed Stirling First rental scheme are demanding justice.
This is disgraceful. People of this age, especially coming out of COVID-19, shouldn't have to do this.
Lost the lot. It was horrible. And it's been the worst 12 months of my life.
More than 100 West Aussies poured their life savings into the Rent for Life scheme, which collapsed in March 2019, leaving some of them homeless. Elderly people are the most at risk of COVID-19, so protesting in the street like this is against all health advice. But these residents say they have nothing left to lose.
We've lost 9 people, they've died, and there's more to come. Being sick, you know, it was just a big rip-off from the beginning.
The case is before the High Court, with ASIC pursuing the company behind the Stirling Trust. But the residents say that ASIC was negligent from the start and the federal government should cough up the $19 million owed to them.
And we've been thieved, we've been robbed, we need our money back. Simple.
Brendan Crew for 10 News First.
The RAC has revealed WA drivers' worst habits after a recent survey. Around 800 drivers were asked to rate the most inconsiderate behaviours on our roads. The results showed we are not very good at indicating or merging, but tailgating is the most annoying.
These aren't just inconsiderate things. These are potentially life-saving issues or will stop a serious injury on our road.
But not pulling over for an emergency vehicle was rated the most inconsiderate driving behaviour. It's not a vaccine, but British scientists have announced the world's first major medical breakthrough in the treatment of coronavirus. They've discovered that a cheap and common steroid drug can substantially increase survival rates among the sickest COVID patients.
It's cheap, safe, and saving the lives of coronavirus patients. A commonly used steroid called dexamethasone, the first major medical breakthrough since the outbreak began.
I think that there is genuine cause to celebrate a remarkable British scientific achievement, the benefits it will bring, not just in this country, but around the world.
It costs about $10 per patient. And for the sickest ones who require ventilators, it reduces deaths by 35%.
There's never been a trial conducted at that speed, at that scale.
The drug has been made available for treatment across the UK, but it's also been used for 60 years to treat respiratory problems and arthritis.
There's plenty of excitement here in the UK this week, not just about the medical breakthrough, but a sense of things returning to a new kind of normal.
The English Premier League returns today. Shops are reopening across England, and the royal lockdown is over after 3 months. Prince Charles and Camilla met with hospital workers.
It's been a marvellous opportunity just to have a chance of seeing people who I know have been doing so much on the, literally on the front line.
While Prince William checked in with paramedics, a touching gesture after a grim few months. Phoebe Bowden for 10 News First, London.
This next report is for all of those getting into DIY around the home. New research has shed light on why so many men fall off ladders and what the experts at Sydney's Westmead Hospital discovered could save lives and some embarrassment.
It's all part of the human life cycle. Learn to walk, learn to climb a ladder, and then keep climbing ladders for the odd job around the home until one day most men fall off.
Within New South Wales, there's probably about 1,700 falls from ladders per year. About 10 people per year die.
For the first time, experts have studied not how many have fallen or how badly, but why men keep doing it.
So they kind of had it fixed in their heads that, well, you know, my dad did it. I've been doing it all my life. I can still do it.
They found home handymen come unstuck because they think they're forever young and they don't do risk assessments.
The surface that the ladder was placed on, the angle at which they placed it against the wall. How well am I to climb the ladder? Am I on any medication?
It's not all the guys' fault though. The experts found they were often let down by their equipment using older two-legged ladders instead of these newer four-legged non-slip varieties.
Of the men aged 50 plus rushed to Westmead Hospital for home reno fails, 50% had fallen off a ladder, 66% suffered multiple injuries, and 25% had severe trauma, like 78-year-old Paul Malloy.
I had five broken ribs, a punctured lung, and my left scapula was fractured.
He's now held together by titanium bands, but his wife Betty was the real fixer-upper. And he's now a retired DIYer. Ali Donaldson for 10 News First.
Four endangered Asian small clawed otter pups have had their first physical health checks at Perth Zoo. The pups, which are now 2 months old, had their eyes, ears and teeth checked and all passed with flying colours. There are three males and one female in the litter. They'll become part of the zoo's breeding program to help safeguard the species from extinction. Goss is back. Some Eagles and Dockers fans, well, they may be very lucky this weekend.
Yeah, absolutely, Monica. Spot on. The Queensland government is allowing crowds to slowly return to footy and rugby league games. That's on the way, and we have the latest from the Gold Coast.
State tourism bodies try to lure Aussies into their own backyard. Plus, big news for the randy reptile with a legendary libido who saved his species.
It is the heart of the home. It's the heart of our family. It's the heart of our social life. We need it to last a long time, and that's where quality comes in. Every kitchen is different. Every size is different. So we have such a great range here.
It's a nice feeling to walk into a brand new kitchen. We definitely make the whole process affordable and easy. So from start to finish, Bunnings makes it super easy to get your state-of-the-art kitchen for your budget.
So to create the amazing look without the big prices, Bunnings Warehouse. Beautiful kitchens at an affordable price that look amazing.
Okay, Dan, you know the drill. No, we don't stop there, Dan. This is new Up & Go No Added Sugar. The goodness of original Up & Go, only now available with no added sugar. Now we're talking, Dan. Now we're talking. New Up and Go, no added sugar. It's next level goodness.
Cookie people, cream people, crumbs people, clean people, twist people, lick people, dunk people, munch people. It's time to play, people. If you twist, lick, dunk, then you're my people. We are Oreo people.
Celtos. Duh. When you feel a tickly sore throat coming on, get rapid relief with Diflam Forte Sore Throat Spray from Chemist Warehouse. The adjustable nozzle directly targets the site of pain. No wonder it's the number one throat spray in Australia. Right now at Chemist Warehouse, Diflam Forte Sore Throat Spray is just $10.99. For more severe pain, try new Diflam Plus Anesthetic Sore Throat Spray with an effective triple action formula. Live, look, feel well at Chemist Warehouse.
It's now more important than ever to eat well, to keep well. Light and Easy's new Winter Wellbeing menu gives you over 100 delicious meals to enjoy, all packed full of nutrients to keep you healthy throughout the colder months. And because over 35% of people put weight on every winter, it'll also help you avoid that winter weight gain. If you want to lose weight, stay healthy and enjoy more free time, eat well and keep well with Australia's number one healthy meal delivery service. Order from Light and Easy's new Winter menu today.
This is Coral. Rather than make assumptions about how she uses her car, we listened. She saved $297 when she switched to Yui.
I'm very happy with the savings.
Coral is retired. She only uses her car to take her elderly mum to appointments and general running around. But in the current crisis, Coral is driving even less. So we thought it was only right to give Coral temporary relief on her car insurance premium.
Everybody's trying to save a bit of money these days.
Yui, you insured.
Please step aside.
Why?
Because I'm chief of police. I get that I'm new. I get how many people think I don't deserve this. Someone in this office leaked to the press to undermine me. I want to know who. I need to know how long it's going to be till my officers trust me.
The new series, Tommy, 8:30 tonight.
Andrew Gaff plays his 200th game on Saturday night against Brisbane, and today the Star Eagle made it clear that he hopes for more milestone moments along the way, indicating he loves Perth and isn't looking to head home to Victoria anytime soon.
Free to finally play, but his first shot off the tee summed up the Eagles' week.
Get up.
Yeah, shanked the first board. The ball looked like the size of an ant on the first tee, so was never going to hit that well.
Take two and a much better result. Andrew Gaff expecting his teammates to keep their eye on the ball against Brisbane.
We expect better of ourselves, and we've got a team that's played a lot of senior football together over so many years, a lot of experienced guys with a lot of success as well, that we expect close to perfection, and that was a long way off that.
Adding to the motivation, Saturday will be the midfielder's 200th appearance. Mr. Consistent, rarely missing a game over his 10 years and expected to trigger a clause in his contract to stay in Eagles colours beyond this season.
I've loved and continue to love every part of playing at this footy club.
His love for West Coast tested when opposition clubs threw multi-million dollar contracts at him at the end of 2018. Gaff was also dealing with an ill father, a lengthy suspension, and the heartache of missing out on a premiership medal.
Very lucky to play at a successful club, and there's no guarantees of whether you get another chance to hopefully win a flag, as Evan wants to do, but everything was and is going really well here.
Skipper Luke Shuey continues to recover from a barrage of bumps on the weekend, but still has time to prove his fitness. It was a big Wednesday for the Dockers on their day off, and no surprise to see Nat Fyfe and Connor Blakely don the wetsuit, grab the board and catch some waves. The AFL easing restrictions on our two teams while they hunker down in the hub, with surfing and golf now permitted.
How you feeling?
Oh, a bit nervous.
Bailey Banfield chasing a few birdies before hitting the books. Lockie Reed for 10 News First.
And the Dockers and the Eagles will have some support at their games this weekend, with the Queensland government allowing a slow trickle of fans into AFL and NRL games. Though for the small number lucky enough to get a ticket, there's a price to pay with strict biosecurity checks before entering the ground.
You can add all the fake crowd noise you like.
The Titans have won it on the bell!
But nothing can replace the real thing.
And today we add the missing ingredient, the fans. As of this Saturday, stadiums can host up to 2,000 fans.
They are the rusted on through and through. They are there day in, day out, through the disappointment, through the good times.
And we're just thrilled to be able to say thank you and please come back to the football.
The Suns, Lions and Titans will roll out an online ballot system for members, but for the lucky winners, it may not be the fan experience they've come to expect.
Everyone will be getting temperature checks. It'll be great fun.
Hopefully this is the precursor to getting more fans as we go forward.
While there's relief from club administrators, it's the players that will benefit as much as anyone.
Yeah, they'll create a bit of an atmosphere, no doubt. Yeah, especially at the Gabba, they're pretty noisy fans coming in.
Probably more when you get that surge late in games, when the crowd really starts to get behind people, get behind their team and tries to influence the ref. That's what you've kind of missed.
But the AFL clubs are already thinking bigger.
We hope to build that up to 25% of the stadium capacity in the weeks to come.
That would be over 6,000 seats filled. Sport is slowly returning to normal. Josh McLean for 10 News First.
Port Adelaide has tonight launched a petition in a bid to wear their famous black and white prison bar jumper in every showdown in the future. Meanwhile, Geelong recruit Jack Stephen will have to play the waiting game as coach Chris Scott plays it safe with the former Saint.
The Little Master was eye-catching in round two. Shorter quarters and a smaller season might just play into the hands of Gary Ablett, but it won't change his coach's plans to give his star a rest at some stage.
I still am of the view that he shouldn't play all 17 games in the home and away season. But again, that's a bit of a suck it and see thing. I'm happy to say last year, if I had my time over again, we would have taken him out before we did.
It wasn't Chris Scott's only concession on last season, admitting he thought Ablett carried a hamstring injury late in the piece.
I didn't think he was at his best physically towards the end of last year. Maybe it's the fact that he's a proud competitor and he doesn't want to use his physical status as a reason for not playing as well as he'd like to.
On the availability of Jack Stephen for Saturday's match with the Blues, Scott let the cat out of the bag within seconds.
He'll play in some capacity this week. Yeah, I'm happy to say more than likely he'll play that practice. I'm not sure.
Fully, fully fit.
Whose name are Justin, his surname starts with L, and they both coach. Langer and Longmuir. Sorry, I'll slow it down for you. I'll slow it down for you. Langer and Longmuir.
Michael Schultz has the forecast after the break. Stay with us.
You just went, whoa.
Oh, wow.
It's the Elimination Challenge. All MasterChef contestants dread.
Oh, I don't want to do this.
It will send one of your favourites home.
This cube challenge is really hard.
Far out.
No.
And they're doing it blindfolded. Blindfolded.
Oh, no.
Oh, my God. Scary.
I'm thinking, ooh.
Oh, that's a tough one. That's a tough one.
I have no idea. No idea.
No, I feel really unsure about this one.
The Blind Elimination, 7:30 Sunday.
You want to break limits, break the mould, and break free. But have you got the bones to do it? 73% of Australian women don't get enough calcium from their diet alone. Boost calcium absorption with Austolin Vitamin D, Australia's number one bone health brand. Have you got the bones to do it? Test yourself at dtest.com.au.
If you're experiencing abuse or domestic violence, contact 1-800-RESPECT for free, confidential advice and counselling, online and by phone 24/7. There's no place for abuse or domestic violence. Help is here. Authorised by the Australian Government, Canberra.
When life gives you dirtiness, Godfrey's gives you cleanliness. With products to keep every surface free from spills, dirt and allergens. For a clean and healthy home, Godfrey's cleanliness.
Service is so good, I signed up my mum.
Another real review from a happy Aussie broadband customer. With thousands of five-star reviews, an award-winning NBN network and all Australian support, you'll want to introduce us to your parents too. Aussie broadband. Can't beat feedback.
There's a glass and a half in everyone.
At Coles, we're helping lower the cost of winter warmers. And what better way than a delicious Coles Kitchen Soup? From creamy butternut pumpkin to chicken and corn, you can mix, match and save any two for just $5. Perfect paired with Coles Stone Baked by Laurent Mini Panna de Casa. Mix, match and save any two for just $4. Never miss any great specials like these. Sign up for the Coles digital catalogue at coles.com.au. Coles, good things, great value.
Lottery West's COVID-19 Relief Fund is helping provide food, clothing and rent assistance to many West Aussies experiencing hardship across our state. Thanks, WA. It's working. Play for WA.
Toss. Duh. Up next, when it comes to inequality, could the pandemic be bringing Australians closer together or driving us further apart? How a freely available and cheap steroid is saving the lives of critically ill COVID-19 patients.
And has Aussie actor Cat Stewart found a way to go around the world during lockdown? The project next.
Good evening. The cold front is moving inland. It's reaching Meriden. There's been 0.4 of a millimetre there and the city's recorded 11.2 millimetres from the system. Here it is on the satellite image and there is still a severe weather warning associated with this feature. It extends from Lake Clifton across to Bremer Bay. South of that line there could be gusts to 100 kilometres an hour. The showers might push as far north as Exmouth and across to Eucla tomorrow, but the trend will be clearing from the northwest. Thunderstorms are likely south of a line Mandra to Israelite Bay and there could also be some small hail. Strong winds, gales, dangerous swells and beach erosion are likely anywhere south of Shark Bay down to Albany, but the gales extend further east to Israelite Bay. Gales on our local waters will ease overnight and become strong west to southwesterlies. We're expecting lighter south to southeasterlies tomorrow evening, but a big swell, 4 to 6 metres. Today it got to 22.7 degrees after an overnight minimum of 9.2. It's currently 18. The winds are west-southwesterly at 19 kilometres an hour. Barometer through 1,009 hectopascals and it's still rising. There could be a thunderstorm and possibly some hail over the southern suburbs overnight and early tomorrow. That takes in Mandra and Dwelling Up. Dwelling Up's expecting a maximum tomorrow of 14 degrees and even in Northam it's going to be much cooler tomorrow, 17. Bickley's expecting 16. Here in the city we're expecting a shower or two clearing during the afternoon. There could be a further 2 to 6 millimetres and there is the possibility of that small hail in the south and the gusty west to southwesterly winds will be moderating. A minimum of 11 and a maximum of 18. Then it clears up. Friday should be partly cloudy with 6 to 18 degrees. Saturday sunny but a colder start, down to 5 before a top of 20. A warmer day on Sunday, mostly sunny, 9 to 22. Monday's a bit like today. It'll start fine but we'll end up with showers. We could get 6 to 15 millimetres of rain and a top around 23 degrees. Showers should linger through Tuesday, 4 to 10 millimetres and a top at 21. And even on Wednesday there could be a further 2 to 5 millimetres with that top of 20 degrees. We need the rain.
We do need the rain. Thanks, Michael. Take care on the wet roads. We look forward to having your company again same time tomorrow. Good night.
See you later. Good night.
Tonight, when it comes to inequality, could the pandemic be bringing Australians closer together or driving us further apart? The federal-